Hey friends! Before we start the show, we want to give a quick shout out to a few members of our Patreon family.
That's right! We want to send a big hola to our amigas Elle and Maggie, their mama Catherine, and their papa Dave. Hola amigos! We heard that you all have some special mascotas or pets that live in a box in your garage. I'll give a few hints to our listeners. They are small, wiggly, they love to eat dirt, and their name in Spanish is gusanos. Any guesses, amigos? If you said worms, muy bien! Elle and Maggie have a box of gusanos in their garage that help them make compost, which is so amazing! Evan and I used to have a compost bin when we lived in Oregon, and we had some gusanos of our own. Worms are so important to keeping the soil and compost healthy, and we hope they're helping you grow lots of beautiful frutas y vegetales. Thank you all so much for being such amazing and eco-friendly listeners, and for all your love and support.
We also want to give a shout out to our amigos Christine, Joshua, and Mary, and their mama Erin. Hola amigos! We think it's so wonderful that you all listen to the show together as a familia. You know, I lived in a familia with three siblings also. I was the middle child, and it was a lot of fun because there was always someone to play games with, like hide and seek, or football, or tennis. It's a lot of fun to have hermanos y hermanas, and it makes us so happy to know that you all are out there listening and learning and laughing together with us. Muchas gracias for all of your love and support, amigos!
And thanks again to everyone in our Patreon familia. Your support is the reason why our show is able to continue. To anyone who would like to join and keep our program going in exchange for really fun Eat Your Spanish worksheets, activities, virtual get-togethers, and song downloads, you can find our Patreon at patreon.com/eatyourspanish or click on the link in the podcast description.
Or if you're interested in having some virtual Spanish lessons, we offer those too. Now on with the show. Hello friends.
Hola amigos.
How are you?
¿Cómo están?
I'm so happy.
Estoy feliz.
To be with you.
A estar contigo.
Are you hungry?
Tienen hambre.
To sing and play.
A cantar y jugar.
'Cause on our menu.
Porque en el menu
es Spanish today. Everybody sing.
Eat your Spanish.
Spinach?
No, I said Spanish.
Okay.
Eat your Spanish with us today.
Eat your Spanish!
With Evan.
And Vanessa.
Hello, friends. Me llamo Evan.
Y me llamo Vanessa. Welcome to the second episode of the Eat Your Spanish Summer Song Series for the year 2024. In this episode, we're going to introduce a special Spanish song to you, tell you a story about why it's special to us, and then translate the words to English for you so that you can understand them. For this week's canción, we would like to introduce you to a song called Mi Tierra Veracruzana by Natalia Lafourcade.
This canción is really special because it's about a very beautiful Spanish-speaking city in Mexico that is the home of the person singing. It's a lot like a love song, except instead of celebrating the beauty of a person, it celebrates the beauty of a city.
That's so true, Evan. I really like how it's a love song about a place. Listening to this song makes me want to write a song about some of my favorite places. The singer of this song, Natalia Lafourcade, has such a beautiful voice, and you can really feel her emotions so strongly.
Yeah, she really does have a beautiful voice, just like you.
Aw, thanks, Evan.
Well, how about we listen to the canción now, and then you can explain to our amigos what all the words mean.
Sounds good to me. Here is one of our favorite songs called Mi Tierra Veracruzana, written and performed by Natalia Lafourcade.
Thank you. Tierra veracruzana, solo quiero tomar café. Un poquito de azúcar y caña, pa' ponerme a mover los pies. De la penca de una banana, de su verde morena piel. Ando toda reenamorada, solo quiero volverte a ver. Volverte a ver, volverte a ver. Mi tierra veracruzana, te quiero ver. Volverte a ver, volverte a ver. Mi tierra veracruzana, te quiero querer. En mi tierra veracruzana, solo quiero abrazar el mar. Ver la noche desde una hamaca, de mañana solo cantar. En el campo enterrar las piernas, en la arena solo bailar. En un barco entregar mis sueños y mi casa pa' huevonear. Volverte a ver, volverte a ver. Veracruzana, te quiero ver. Volverte a ver, volverte a ver. Mi tierra veracruzana, te quiero querer. No hay un día que pase que no te piense. Esta lejanía me hace extrañarte. No hay un día que pase que no te piense. Pinto melodías con tus paisajes. Pasión, volverte a ver, volverte a ver. Yo te quiero querer, volverte a ver, volverte a ver.
So that song is so beautiful, but I'm not really sure about what all the words mean. Do you think you can help translate them for me and for all of our listeners?
Of course. The first words sound like this. En mi tierra veracruzana, solo quiero tomar café, un poquito de azúcar y caña, pa' ponerme a mover los pies. Which in English means, in my Veracruz land, I just want to drink coffee with a little bit of sugar and cane to help me start moving my feet. The next words sound like this.
De la penca de una banana, de su verde y morena piel, ando todo re enamorada, solo quiero volverte a ver.
Which in English means, the stem of a banana, her green and brown skin, I fall in love with it all again, I just want to see you again. Next comes the chorus, which is the part of the song that repeats, and it sounds like this.
Volverte a ver, volverte a ver, mi tierra veracruzana, te quiero ver.
To see you again, to see you again, my land of Veracruz, I want to see you. Then the last part of the chorus sounds like this.
Mi tierra veracruzana, te quiero querer.
My Veracruz land, I love to love you. It's really nice to hear how much she loves her home. In the next part of the song, she goes on to list some of her favorite things to do in the special places she loves in Veracruz. In Spanish, she says, En mi tierra veracruzana, solo quiero abrazar el mar, ver la noche desde una hamaca, de mañana solo cantar. In English, this part means, In my Veracruz land, I just want to hug the sea, to see the night from a hammock, and just sing in the morning. The next verse in Spanish is, En el campo enterrar las piernas, en la arena solo bailar, en un barco entregar mis sueños, y mi casa para huevonear, which in English means, to bury my legs in the field, to just dance in the sand, to send off my dreams on a boat, and to goof off in my house. Then the chorus repeats again, volverte a ver, mi tierra veracruzana te quiero ver, mi tierra veracruzana te quiero querer. To see you again, my land of Veracruz, I want to see you. My Veracruz land, I love to love you. The next verse talks about how she misses her home and is followed by a really magical verse where she uses fruits and other special things from Veracruz to talk about how they add color to her life and her music. Her words sound like this. No hay un día que pase y que no te piense. Esta lejanía me hace extrañarte. No hay un día que pase y que no te piense. Pinto melodías con tus paisajes. This part means, there is not a day that goes by that I don't think of you. The distance makes me miss you. There is not a day that goes by that I don't think of you. I paint melodies with your landscapes. And now here comes the fruits and other special images that she uses to paint her music with. Those words sound like this. Con tus paisajes de verde limón, una rosa guayaba que uso para el amor, un rojo amarillo pitaya y la flor, azul de tu golfo y rojo pasión. Which in English means, with your lime green landscapes, a pink guava, which I use for love, red and yellow from pitaya and its flower, the blue of your gulf and red for passion. Pitaya might be a new word for some of you listening, and that's just the name of a tropical fruit. Next, the chorus repeats, and then something really magical happens. A chant of Café con Pan comes in and repeats a few times. Before I started reading more about this song, I would have just thought that this meant coffee with bread, which is a traditional thing to have for breakfast in lots of Spanish-speaking countries. But once I started reading more about this specific song, I learned that Café con Pan is a chant used when teaching a special kind of dance from Veracruz called El Son Jarocho. This chant is used because the syllables, café con pan, mimic the rhythm of the steps that are used to do the dance. It's kind of like the way people use the words boots and cats to teach people how to beatbox.
Boots and cats and boots and cats and boots and cats.
Yeah, exactly. Good job, Evan. But instead of boots and cats, in her hometown of Veracruz, they use the phrase café con pan. Café con pan, to teach people how to dance El Son Jarocho. Then the chorus repeats again, followed by the last word of the song, bamba, which is just one of many San Jarocho dances. And that's the whole song. This canción has such a beautiful and multi-layered connection to Veracruz. Natalia Lafourcade not only has such a passionate way of making music, but the richness of her connection to her culture is what really makes her music shine. I'm so glad we get to share her special music with you.
Yeah, me too. It really is such a beautiful and powerful song.
And it really makes me want to visit Veracruz too.
Yeah, me too.
Well, amigos, now that we know the story of this song and what all of the words mean, let's listen to it one more time. Here is Mi Tierra Veracruzana by Natalia Lafourcade.
Y caña pa' ponerme a mover los pies de la penca de una banana, de su verde morena piel. Ando toda reenamorada, solo quiero volverte a ver, volverte a ver, volverte a ver. Mi tierra veracruzana te quiero ver, volverte a ver. Mi tierra veracruzana, te quiero querer. En mi tierra veracruzana, solo quiero abrazar el mar. Ver la noche desde una hamaca, de mañana solo cantar. En el campo enterrar las piernas, en la arena solo bailar. En un barco entregar mis sueños y mi casa pa' huevonear. Volverte a ver, volverte a ver. Mi tierra veracruzana, te quiero ver. Volverte a ver, volverte a ver. Mi tierra veracruzana, te quiero querer. No hay un día que pase que no te piense. Esta lejanía me hace extrañarte. Pasión, volverte a ver, volverte a ver. Yo te quiero querer, volverte a ver, volverte a ver.
Thanks again for listening to the song Mi Tierra Veracruzana with us. Now that we've learned so much about this special canción, that can only mean one thing. Time for two of our very special amigos to take over the show for a while.
Take it away, you two.
Gracias, Evan. Gracias, Vanessa. Y hola, amigos. It's time to answer a pregunta from one of our special Patreon supporters. Drum roll, please. Today's special listener is Vidya! Vidya, what is your question?
Hi, my name is Vidya, and I really want to know how to say teddy in Spanish. Thank you, adios.
Oh, wow, Vidya, what a lovely pregunta. I had quite a few teddies growing up that I literally loved to pieces. It takes a whole lot of teddies to make an elefante extra cozy. I think I had at least a baker's dozen. What about you, Mr. Mouse? Did you have any special teddies growing up?
I sure did. I actually still have a couple of them. But if I'm being honest, my most special comfort object is kind of, how do I explain this? Unconventional.
Oh my, well, coming from you, that sure is saying something. All right, spill the beans, Mr. Mouse. What is it?
Well, maybe I should tell you the story of how I found it so you have a little context. I was a tiny little toddler mouse, and I was going through the big feelings phase of my toddler days. Well, mi familia was taking a walk outside on the rough and tumble streets of New York City when I slipped on a loose pickle on the sidewalk and wham! I fell tail over toes onto the hard sidewalk. I was about to really start crying until I realized something soft and a little crispy had patted my fall. It was a dried up gusano, or worm, and the rest is history. From then on, my little crispy dried worm amigo was my number one teddy, and in all honesty, I still have him. He's in my banana bed right now, keeping it cozy for me.
Oh, me. Oh, my. I couldn't have dreamed that up if I'd tried to, Mr. Mouse. Whew, you sure have a unique and rich life, especially for a little mouse.
Thanks, Mrs. Elephant. Well, would you like to know how to say teddy in Espanol?
Oh, yeah, I almost forgot. I would love to know.
To say teddy, you say oso de peluche. So repeat after me, amigos. Oso de peluche.
Oso de peluche.
Oso de peluche.
Oso de peluche.
Muy bien, amigos.
Yeah, great work. Thanks for the fantastic question, Vidya, and for being such a wonderful listener.
Now that we've answered your great question, that can only mean one thing.
Time to sing the goodbye song.
You got it, Mrs. Elephant.
Adios, mi buen amigo.
Goodbye, my good friend.
Hasta luego.
See you later.
See you later, my good friend.
Adios, amigos. Goodbye, friends.
Hasta luego. See you later.
Thanks for listening to the Eat Your Spanish podcast. You can support our podcast by visiting patreon.com/eatyourspanish or by subscribing to it and leaving a review on Apple Podcasts. You can also find us on Facebook, Instagram, or on the web at eatyourspanishpodcast.com. Thanks for listening. Adios!